Bobby Simmons is in the building. Welcome back to the show. And you know, I had to bring some people with me in this show, y'all, because the only time that we have fun, well, we actually have fun, you know, pretty much all morning because we have the Morning Maniac music. But I brought some guests in the building with me, y'all, ladies and gentlemen. The one and only, well, I got two of them. So let me just introduce them, you know, how they're supposed to be introduced. First, we got coming up right now, we got Jazz Anderson is in the building and Zonique Pullin. In the building. How y'all doing, ladies?
Good.
How you doing? Now, Zonique, now help me out, because I know sometimes when I hear people say your name, they say Zonique or Zonique. Or, please tell me how to say it, because I don't want to say it wrong.
It's Zonique. A lot of people do say Zonique. Yes, it's Zonique.
Because I'm saying, I hear people, you know, say Zonique, and I'm like, okay. And then someone told me, no, it's Zonique. I'm like, well, I'm going to ask her. She'll tell me how to pronounce it.
Yes.
First of all, thank y'all ladies for taking the time to join me today on the show. And we have something that I really want to talk about real quick. Watching y'all do y'all thing with this brand new show, which is called The Mix. And what I'm going to let you do, no disrespect, can I call you Zoe, please? Can I say
For sure, that's easy.
You know, Zoe, because this show was actually created and presented by not one of your family, but your mom's. Who actually put the show together. Please tell us a little bit about this show.
So this show is, you know, a talk show for the younger generation. You know, my mom, she's always coming up with all these crazy ideas, all these show ideas. And, you know, she saw how a lot that was going on in the world and just how the younger generation didn't stand down for or hasn't been standing down for anything. And, you know, we've been speaking up and, you know, we say our opinion and we don't let anybody crowd that. So she was like, y'all need your own show. Like, there's no talk show for, you know, you guys that people can relate to. And, you know, just have somewhere to go. So The Mix is all of that. You know, we have five of us with five different opinions, five different personalities. And, you know, it's really just like a conversation between the five of us. And we talk all topics, important politics, sex, everything.
Now, I don't want to throw people off because people probably look and say, well, who's the moms? We're talking about Tamika Tiny. Y'all know it's Tiny Harris from the group, the R&B, platinum R&B group. Doing his thing. And also Jazz Anderson, we're not gonna let you go because I'm you know, in respectful way, I'm coming at you because for those who don't know, Jazz Anderson, whose father, a former NBA player, Kenny Anderson, you know, here's what I want to ask you. Do you give up basketball, or is that still a part of like your life?
No, I actually, I played college ball. I went Division I college basketball, but I ended up getting injured. So I just got overwhelmed pretty much with the physical rehab, was on crutches, wheelchair, all that. I said, I'm done with this. So, yeah, you could say I wouldn't say I gave it up, but I would say my time is done with basketball for sure.
Right. So you're saying at this point, it doesn't even look like you'll probably even be going to even dabbling anymore.
Well, I mean, I go play pickup games at like the gym, but right. No, not on a serious level.
Right. Now with this show, Jazz Anderson, because like you know, said, Zoe said that everybody has an opinion, you know, in the show. When y'all talk about certain topics, do y'all bump heads with each other? Because I'm sure like this is like The View. This is like the young generation of The View. I'm sure y'all all have to bump heads on certain topics. Have that happened yet at all?
Honestly, that hasn't happened. I think what's so great about The Mix is that, yeah, we do have different opinions, different perspectives, but we can agree to disagree. And that's what I love about all the co-hosts. It's like, okay, I understand where you're coming from, but I can't agree. And this is where I'm coming from. And I want you to agree with me. Right. You know what I'm saying? So we always do that. But no, we don't bump heads too often. We just give our opinions. Okay. But I think that's important.
Oh, exactly. Because, you know, when people watch the show, and I know y'all getting it, like Zoe said, she said, you know, we do politics, we do certain topics. Yes. And I'm sure everybody can look at things a little bit differently. But Zoe, please, you know, though you have mentioned there's five people, who are the other people part of the show with you guys on the show, The Mix?
So we got Romeo, me and Jazz, Jamie, who is our youngest, she's 18, and Anton Peoples.
Okay, right. And for those, you know, everybody knows that she said Romeo Miller, which is this, who's the son of famous entrepreneur and rap artist Master P. How did y'all all come together to even do this show? Was it that y'all all were friends, or you were all picked to say, hey, you can be this new generation of group to speak, you know, use this as a panel to speak to your generation people to do the show? How did all of you guys come together like, this is the crew, the show, the mix that you can speak to your audience?
You know, we actually went through like an auditioning process, like, you know, in LA, we all switched out. It was a lot of us in one room, and we all, you know, they switched us out and see who meshed with who. And then they got a couple of us and was like, okay, you know, let's start doing Zoom calls. Then we start doing it on Zoom and, you know, getting the feel of how just the five of us do when we switch out between five people. And, you know, it was like that. It really wasn't a long auditioning process, I wouldn't say. I feel like they knew like who gelled together quick.
Oh, I mean, and that's interesting for people to know too, because your family, both you, or actually mostly all of y'all have family members who've, you know, been down this pipeline before. You would have thought that they would have, you know, y'all all had the audition to be a part of this show. You would have just thought like, hey, get your best friend. But this is really interesting. No. I mean, because, you know, certain people when they do shows like, well, that's my homegirl. I want her on the show because that's my peoples. And, you know,
not
like that. It's like she actually broke it down like, well, no, we had to see who was going to gel with who, you know, this show was going to work. And actually, I watched one of the episodes of the show. Actually, I watched the first episode. I'm gonna air where you brought your stepdad and your mom on the show to talk and stuff like that. What I'm looking forward for y'all to do, because again, this is the generation in politics, and we got this whole, you know, Democratic Party and Republican Party.
That us as the younger generation, we're on social media 24/7. You know what I'm saying? We're in the front lines. We're at the protests. We're at the rallies. So we have to be that voice.
Yes.
It has to come from us. I always say I feel like the older generations. No offense, but y'all kind of stuck in y'all ways. Like, it's like,
okay, I'm the oldest. But go ahead, I'm listening.
I don't know. Like, when I talk to the older generation, it's like they feel like, oh, we've been here before. We'll get through this. Even when it came to the pandemic, they felt like, it's okay. We'll get through this. We survived slavery. Like, I was hearing that a lot. And I'm like, just wear your mask. But, you know, it's like the younger generation, we have to be that voice.
Pandemic, we going to be our. I know, just me, I love to hear the generation speak, because it's important to me to know exactly what direction we're going to be moving in. And before I let you girls go, one more question I do want to ask, because like you said, those are going to be topics, hopefully, not even hopefully, you just said those are topics that you're going to be attacking more on. And I'm glad.
Yeah.
Yeah, but if I can ask you, Zoe, quickly, you know, particularly the situation that just happened in Wisconsin with the police still shooting our young brothers, you know, unarmed men, that's going on out there. Please, briefly, real quick, just tell me you guys feeling, and what do you think that can change so that more our brothers and sisters can stop being harmed and killed by the police department at such a violent way when we're unarmed, when our brothers and sisters are unarmed?
You know what? It's such a terrible thing just to see, to be witnessing, especially since this pandemic. I feel like all we have is to focus and see what's really going on out in the world. So all, especially my generation, want to do is, you know, get out there and do whatever we can to be a part and to help our community. I feel like, you know, I don't know. The system is just so messed up. And I feel like, you know, it targets black men, black people as a whole. It's really, you know, it's just something that you hate to see, especially having brothers and having kids on the way. For me, it's just like, you know, we just feel like we have to do something We have to do something to change, whether it's go and vote and be a part, do our research, and just figure it out. As you said, our generation is what's next, so.
So again, this show, The Mix, which is on Fox Souls and Tuesdays, am I right? Every Tuesday.
Yes.
Tuesday at what time?
7 p.m. Pacific, 10 p.m. Eastern.
10 p.m. Pacific. And listen, I want everybody that's listening on to please tune in and watch the show. I, you know, did see the first episode. I love what you guys are doing on there.
Thank you.
I'll let y'all go. Congratulations to you, Zoe, because people don't know. They need to know now that you're about to be a mommy yourself. That's a beautiful thing. And also it's a beautiful thing that you're doing what you're doing for this platform, because you get to now open up the way for your next generation, or for your children's generation, or your child generation to, because we want to see change. And I truly believe that you, Jazz Anderson, Enzo, that you are the change. And with this show, The Mix, everyone definitely should watch, hear what they have to say, let them speak. All the topic is not politics. They're going to have all kinds of topics. But is it, you know, for us, it is important for y'all to make sure you spread the word as much as you definitely can. And we'll appreciate it. We appreciate you guys' work. I will be watching. So,
Thank you so much.
And I will continue to show y'all more love. And hopefully, as when this pandemic ends and y'all get the chance to fly through New York City, please come by to our iHeart Studios and hang out and continue to just keep doing more, because we want to see y'all do it. So we appreciate y'all for what
y'all
do. Thank
you so much.
Thank you, Bobby.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Check out the show on Fox Soul TV Network, The Mix, with Jazz Anderson and Zonique in the building. Thank you so much for joining me. Y'all be safe, all right?
Thank you. You too.
We'll be back, y'all.